My name is Inshah. I am from Kashmir. We are in Turkey right now and we will be going to Lebanon maybe in the evening.
I'm from Kashmir, marred by memory of oppression, violence and occupation, still struggling for an identity of my own.
Before 30th March, we have to be there at the border.
Why?
Because 30th March is the global day for people who will assemble there on 30th March. We can't do it beyond that.
Not yet. It's still in the process. So it's taking long time.
So
long
we're going to stay here tonight?
We don't know. So Mushahid is going to find out if he can have it.
I understand what it means to be in a place where you are screaming at the highest of your voice, but nobody listens to you. And there's a huge wall which does not let the voice cross the wall. And if that movement can do this for Palestinian people, I think we have achieved our objective.
The journey began thousands of kilometers away from New Delhi, India, at an organization in South. It was a relentless work spread over several weeks, laced with preparation for a forward-moving struggle. Activists from across India gathered in India's capital city, New Delhi. And with them, they brought their own experiences of various struggles.
Chile and Argentina are also here. This time, it's an Asian, and it's also some internationals in South America. So, this whole work, which is the internal dynamics,
while we were gathering and our interactions were becoming stronger, another group of activists were organizing and getting ready in Indonesia.
Against us. It's called CIF Watch. They are trying to associate us with terrorism.
And we go to Pakistan for 4 days. We Indians are flying from Zaidan, from Karachi to Zaidan. We are in Iran for 5 days, then to Turkey for 5 days, and we take a ship and we go to Beirut. And then some of our friends will fly from there to Jordan. This is the plan.
No.
Bandar Abbas.
Karachi, Tehran, or Karachi, Zahedan, it's different, Mali.
Yes.
What about this?
Yeah. Just go to Karachi. Karachi.
The journey brought together people divided by borders, by identity markers, and by barriers of modern nation states.
Now the point is
it was an intense emotional experience meeting people from different linguistic and religious backgrounds. As a Kashmiri whose land is divided and occupied and remains a 60-year-old dispute in the modern history, much like Palestine, this event was to carry me to another region assaulted by a continual memory of military occupation.
My name is Kunal Majumdar. I'm here to cover the event on behalf of Tehelka News Magazine. In the sense that it's a multinational event in that sense, because you see activists coming from different parts of the world. For activists, I guess it's like a pilgrimage. I mean,
please tell me your name, where you come from, and why you're here. In a very brief.
I'm Rajni Saxena from Lucknow, India. Initially, I wasn't aware of the movement. I wasn't briefed about it till I reached Pakistan and I came to know. And then, yes, gradually I started slipping into the field. And I'm enjoying myself and loving to meet people here. I feel very happy that I am a part of the movement. This was my second all my life.
My name is Vijay Chauhan and I'm from Mumbai, India.
Where are you? Why are you here?
I'm here to because I feel that I must participate in such global peace march. I emphasize the word peace. I believe in peace, and many of the national, international issues and problems can be resolved through such people's participation. I have a firm belief in that, and that's why I'm here.
My name is Arif. I'm from Mumbai, India. I'm in GMJ because I believe in the cause of Palestine, and I believe that it's a most critical issue, geopolitical issue of present time. That's why I participated in this Asian convoy, because I also believe in justice and peace. And we Asian people, this Asian convoy gives strength to the struggle of the Palestine.
I'm Fadil Abbas. I'm here to present Palestinian students in Pakistan and Asia. I'm here to go back to my country as a Palestinian, as a refugee Palestinian, that I've been there before 15 years and I want to go back again. So I wish this march will success and all of us will be there in Jerusalem.
What is the meaning of this global march? Because people come from different countries, they have their own politics. How do you think is this going to help us?
In this caravan, the Asian caravan, the people have been traveling since a long time, long distance, have experienced that Palestinian refugees did before 64 years.
In the region which vociferously supports the cause of Palestine and has also won a global award for projecting this overt support and standing by it.
Welcome.
Hello.
How
are you?
Thank you. Welcome.
Thank you.
عنوان یک فعال اجتماعی از شهرستان زاهدان خدمت همه عزیزان خیر مقدم عرض می کنم. حمایت از آرمان فلسطین دیگر محدود به ایران نیست بلکه متعلق به همه جهانیان است و نماد و نمونه اون شماها هستید.
Caravan was a borderless wall in itself, but each of its participants still owned a flag. No flag mattered to me anymore except of Palestine, because that is what was unifying us as one people. Our own political baggages had been laid to rest. Now we had become travelers with no belonging and no abode, and marching was our only desire.
Having a political governance which is close to people, and I'm really amazed, and especially I think everybody is moved by the fact that the strength and power that Iranian people are showing in the face of Zionist regime.
Jerusalem moves Muslims because of division of the Masjid Aqsa to Kubbatul Sakra, the Haram Sharif. Jerusalem moves the Christians because of divisions of the Holy Sepulchre and also of the Church of the Nativity in Bethlehem. It includes people of all religions. It includes Hindus. It includes Sikhs. It includes Buddhists. Jerusalem unites humanity. From the CNN to the Haaretz to the Jerusalem Post to the Yedioth, all of them are targeting the entire Asian convoy to all the other foreign delegates who are coming to Jerusalem. And that is why we say that we have already achieved the first objective of what we set out to do. The global, the regional, and the entire international geopolitical situation is changing very rapidly and in our favor.
Separation was difficult, since people lived with each other and lived in similar ways, sharing life, fear, sorrow and happiness.
من زیاد زبان بلد نیستم، فقط در حد چند کلمه، ولی اینقدر خوب با هم ارتباط برقرار کردیم که اصلا الان دارم میرم واقعا نمیدونم چجوری بگم، دارم برای تک تکشون تنگ میشه.
Fatima's face still comes in my dreams. A third generation Kashmiri living in Iran. She spoke Farsi and could hardly exchange any meaningful sentences. Her eyes bore the truth of love and perhaps her pain or search of her own identity. I was parting from her at the border in Iran as she bid me goodbye, her eyes filled with tears, and she handed me a Palestinian flag as a gift, perhaps a symbol of resistance. Her eyes too had borne a dream, and I had to but strive for it.
Israel, you can hide. Reza, don't you cry, Palestine will never die.
Reza, don't you cry, Palestine will never die.
Reza, don't you cry, Palestine never go. Reza, Habib
Bakın söhbet, Hud söhbeti, Siyonist söhbeti, bir diktatör söhbeti değil. Hansa bir ağıldan kemin söhbeti değil. Bu söhbet bir rejimin, bir cerayanın söhbeti.
امت اسلامی بلکه مسئله تمام آزادی خواهان جهان
از تمام ادیان و مذاهبی است که عدالت، حقانیت و آزادی برای آنها هنوز موضوعیت دارد.
Tells me that despite I see sun setting in front of me, tomorrow it's gonna rise in my back, and that will be a support. Everybody who stands at my back is a support for me, despite I'm looking at destruction.
To Beirut, so it's about who pays and all that stuff. All that is happening between the.
So when do we?
اینجا رسیدیم که از ساعت 9:30 پاسپورتامون رو جمع کردن، گفتن که پاسپورت رو جمع بکنیم که بریم، حالا بحث ویزا ها چک بشه و اینا. هیچ خبری ندادن تا 6 ساعت بعد اومدن، تازه برگاهی که بخواستن پاسپورت رو بنویسن افراد و تازه توضیح کردن.
Signal from our friends in the black shirts, and our visas are done. Be a little patient, but they have given us a thumbs up. All right, so just carry
all
on.
Of, all
we are okay. We are okay.
All
okay.
Of.
تو پیگه خلوت روحانیان و سینه سوزان،
مسلمان مسلح با سلاح نور ایمان تو شمشیر خدا بر قلب کفار گرانجان قریب لا تخف زرده قریب لا تخف زرده به گلبانگ مسلمان به گلبانگ مسلمان
Members of caravan left the ship one after the other. The process took a whole day. We are told that we'll be able to leave the ship soon after the Iranians. Iranians could leave the ship, and it seems we have to sleep on the ship on one more night.
اندیو گفتن آزاد شدن ولی شنیدم میخوان آزاد شن هنوز خبر نداریم
منتظریم که بیان ولی دیگه نمیدونم دیگه
حالا چی شد نیومدن این هندی ها هیچ کدوم
نه ما منتظریم
چی شد خبر چی شد
چی میرسن الان دارم پیاده میشم فکر کنم تا اگه
هنوز اونجا پس
آره هنوز حرکت نکردم ولی مشکلشون هر چیزی دارم پیاده میشم
به شما اون میرسن یا نه
نمیدونم انشالله که برسن میرم داستانی
آره بابا
Sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You are welcome in Lebanon. Now you are near Palestine.
It is 30th of March, the global day for Palestine, also known as the Land Day. After overcoming the odds we faced during the march, we are moving finally to the Lebanon-Palestine border to register the protest against the State of Israel for their continued oppression and occupation of Palestinian people and their land.
people here joined with us, not only Asian now. Before, our slogan is one Asia, united Asia. But now, Europa, they are Italian, they are, you know, Germany, they are United States, they are Dutch. So, all together, five continents in the short Lebanon protest to Israel. Israel have no friend anymore. Palestine have many, many friends to all over the world.
We were teachers, we were pharmacists, we were physicians, we were doing all the, like any other nation, any other people. And they just came, used their arms, and they kicked our parents, grandparents out of the country, and they took homes, and now we are just refugees. But we can tell them that even my daughter, third generation, and my son, third generation, who were born out of the land, their land, but they will not forget. They know the name of each street in their homeland. They know the name of each village. And if you ask my daughter, from where are you? She will tell you, I'm from Palestine. She will not tell you, I'm Canadian. She will not tell you, I came from Syria. She will tell you, I'm Palestinian.
What it means to be moving in those lanes and being asked for an identity card by a foreign soldier in your own country every day, every moment, every morning, every night. It's a very intense feeling. You wouldn't understand it because you grew up with a flag, you grew up with an identity. But we, like people who are in oppressed countries, they need to show their identity card constantly to the foreigners who are in their land, occupying them.